Hello guys, I am Gorilla Gaming and welcome to the Birmingham City Rebuild. Now, first things first, I need some money to rebuild. We're going to stick it on Loose Disabled. And for this, we are well sticking into the Champions League. Sorry, Liverpool. But Birmingham's going to have to be put into there. We've also placed them into the Premier League, which means we've got to be doing some rebuilding. We've all advanced, and we're going to hope to get some glory in this. Now, the rules are, every game's got to be simulated, except for the Champions League final, if we make it. So I'm just going to go on that, save. We're not going to accept any of these, but so this is the team we've got to work with right now. It's not too great, I think, definitely. Got to bring in some players to help the squad out. And the first player I'm going to bring out and is probably the biggest player in the... is one of the biggest players in the world, and I'm going to try and bring in Kylian Mbappe to give us a boost up front, and we will approach to buy. We're in talks with Mauricio Pochettino to get Mbappe. It's gonna cost us a lot though, so I'm gonna try for 190 million plus Riley McCree. That's a fair deal. To get Mbappe. And then I'm gonna start thinking of other signings to make for the video. So 262 million, we can do that. But we don't have much more money to spend. But for Kylian Mbappe, we'll accept it. I'm hoping to maybe do a... I might do a Birmingham City career mode later in FIFA 22. But this is probably going to be my only FIFA 21 video I'm ever going to make. So I want to make it a banger. I'm just going to delegate for Mbappe. And we are going to try and get the next player we would like. Nick Pope as the young goalkeeper, decent rating. I would like to try and get a hold of him. So we are going to go into contract negotiations with Sean Dyche. This might be a long video because on PlayStation there's no way to edit the trim or trim the videos. So that's why we do have to go through a lot of these. So I'm just going to go to for 30 million and we're going to try and get Nick Pope for 30 million. That's a fair amount of money. He's also a decent goalie. Two. Another player I think I might bring in is Jude Bellingham. After Birmingham sold them, they've retired the cert number. So I'm going to try and get in Jude Bellingham as well. Just to strengthen up the midfield. Now, I'm hoping to make at least 10 signings to strengthen up the squad a wee bit. But some of them will be a lot smaller like this one, and others will be bigger like Mbappe. We'll just delegate as well. And the next player I'm hoping to get, like I said, is going to be Jude Bellingham. Now what I would like to do though, is I'm just going to delegate that and get straight into contract negotiations, and we're going to offer him 50k. All the way to 250k. It's a wee bit much, but I want to try and get him in. Alright, 7 more signings to go. And we could use another striker. So I'll go with not a high rating player, but Rebic, I think he's quite decent. So we'll just delegate to buy, and I'm going to offer 26 million for him, and don't go higher than 46 million. Hopefully we can get Rebic in, because he is quite decent. Now, we need a couple more signings, and I could use a bench player. So I think I'm going to try and get a hold of Alexis Sanchez, as he is quite decent. He's still 80 rated, 31-year-old, would like him. Alright, next up, I could use another midfielder. Because we've got the formation, and we've got to keep the formation as the thing to have quite a decent. So I am hoping to keep the formation. So Nick Pope, and we're going to have Bellingham, we're going to have Rebic up top, we're going to have Alexis Sanchez and Kylian Mbappe. So the other five signing I'm hoping to make is a centre-back, maybe two centre-backs, a defender, so two centre-backs and a full-back. That would be three, so I'd be eight. And then I could sign a right-winger and a left and a midfielder. That would be us sorted. So I'm going to skip a couple of days to try and bring in all these players. Just going to do this. And we do have all of these in. So Mbappe's in. Alexis Sanchez has accepted this. We've accepted that for Rebic. And we've now can't get Rebic. We get Jude Bellingham and we also get in Nick Pope. But unfortunately we've missed out on Rebic. So can't get him now. Because I've made a huge mistake there. Sure, I don't really care about that. I'm going to also accept this because it gives us not much money, but a little bit extra money. So I'm just going to add everyone that we've just got. And Jude Bellingham will go in. Nick Pope will also go in for some decent signings. Let's continue to strengthen the squad. Now, I feel really bad for this one because Saka has got a lot of hate from missing the penalty in the Euros. So I'm going to hopefully try and get Saka in, as all the racist abuse just isn't fair on him because we missed the penalty. So if we get Saka in, then that would be good. I know the sound quality probably isn't great. I can't hear it right now, but I will probably be able to hear it after the video. So if I know it's probably not great because I'm using a PlayStation mic, but I am enjoying making content. And we can't get Saka because apparently he's not worth, how much is Saka worth? I'm pretty sure he's like worth like 35 million, something like that. So again, it's another player we now can't get, which is unfortunate. So we're just going to try and get Alexis Sanchez in at this point now. But I do need a centre-back. And I think I've got to go with an aging one, honestly. Jerome Boateng. He's a wee bit old, but I would like to try and get him in. And speaking of old, Thomas Müller. Which would be a really good signing to try and get a hold of. Where is he? There it is, Thomas Müller. He's quite a lot of money though, but he's a decent player, so I'm gonna skip a couple of days to try and get these three players in. And I'm just hoping to get them in. I'm gonna skip to the end of the week. So that should be this guy sold. Boateng has agreed. Müller has agreed. And Alexis Sanchez is in. And we're just going to try and get Müller and Boateng as well. So we now can add Alexis Sanchez to the team. And a striking partnership of Mbappe and Sanchez is actually quite good. Just play him right forward, and that works. So Mbappe and Sanchez up top is quite good. So we're gonna try and keep going. We are low on money now, so some of them might not be too great of players. We're gonna try and just bring in as many as we can. So I'm just gonna continue to skip a couple of days. They'll skip to that. Hopefully Boateng and Müller have accepted we both have accepted. I'm bringing Boateng, and we also bring in Muller. So that's two more really good players, and we only have 20 million to spend now, which isn't too much money. So I'll have to take this guy out for Muller. And Boateng goes into the back line. I think we've got to play with a strange formation here, as I would like to play Muller at a right, at a cam. So I'll just put him there, honestly. Strange, yeah, I know, but... So how many players is that? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We can only bring in 4 more players. But I do have to think about now, because we don't have too much money. So I might have a look at any transfer-listed players. So there's a transfer-listed decent player that we could try and get a hold of. I think I've got... I think that's all we need to do, actually. Team's looking good, but we could try and make one more signing, but I don't think we'd get very far. So what I would like to do is I'm going to try and sign... I'm going to try and sign a better left back, and it's going to be hopefully Danny Rose. I've put the wrong Rose. He's the North. Yeah. But I'm hoping to bring in Danny Rose, as I think I have just enough money for him. Yeah, I actually do. He's cheap. He's a cheap guy. And I could use another centre back. So I think I'm going to try and get a hold of Eric Dier as well. And I don't know how much he is, but I only have like 16 million, so I can try and I can start the offer at 16 million and I think that's 16k. I can start the offer at 16 million and don't go higher than 18 million. Hopefully we bring those, because they would be huge defensive upgrades if we could get them. I'm actually getting used to the FIFA 21 songs by now, so I think I'm definitely gonna miss them when we go into FIFA 22, but I've not heard them yet. But apparently the FIFA 22 soundtrack is quite decent. I just like a soundtrack with all the best songs and like The Nights by Avicii, things like that. Danny Rose has accepted, and he is almost signing in. I'm just going to skip to the end of the week. Quan, is Dyer going to accept? No, he is not accepting. Which means I don't know if we're going to get him now. Yeah, breakdown. We don't have much money left. I'd say we just go into the rest of the season list as a team. Will we win anything? Probably not, but... I'd like to see what we could do. So... we're going to skip ahead. And we're gonna just skip all the way just to June 1st. And we're gonna see how we're doing. So I'm not gonna talk about any of these games because I don't want it being spoiled for me. But some different career mode content will be coming out, as well as Ultimate Team content will be coming out for FIFA 22. I'm gonna try and make a Ultimate Team Road to Glory, as well as some cool career mode content. That's what at least I'm hoping to do. Because I'd like to make a lot more videos and try and make a fan base. As if you guys have been watching my videos, you know I'm aiming for 50 subscribers by the end of the year. It's a big goal, but I reckon we can do it. Because already, I only made this YouTube channel this morning. And we're already, I think, what, like 7 subscribers? 6 maybe? Which is actually quite decent for just making it. I am hoping to... do well, but I don't know, honestly. From looking at some of the score lines, I don't think we're gonna win anything, honestly. I don't think we went through in the Champions League, but I've got some ideas for a career mode next year. For FIFA 22, I've got a Paris FC one to make them the best team in France and the Champions League. Maybe Celtic to continue Ange Postecoglou's rebuild. Like to just Sunderland, because they're not too great right now. Like, they were Premier League giants at one point, and now they're, well, not Premier League giants, but so I am hoping to do that, as well as a Tottenham and Barcelona career mode, because they're quite big, but they're been quite poor recently, and a creative club, maybe a Sutton United. It really depends what I'm looking like, what I'm feeling we could do. But I'm just hoping that we're going to be able to be quite good in this YouTube thing, as I've been watching YouTube practically my whole life, and I'm finally getting to do it properly. I've had a couple channels before, but they've failed miserably, so I'm hoping Gorilla Gaming can be the big one. And I've also got a good idea to call my fan base the Gorilla Gang, because it sounds cool. So, Gorilla Gang, that's what I'm going to call you lot now, because I think it's just a cool name. But I think that's all our matches done. Have we done well in the league though? Alright, so 20th is Burnley, 19th is Brighton, 18th is Newcastle, 17th is West Brom, 16th is Fulham, 15th is Crystal Palace, 14th is Leeds United, 13th is Southampton, 12th is Aston Villa, 11th is Wolves, 10th is West Ham, 9th is Chelsea. Wow, they've been poor. 8th is us, so we got 8th, so that's not too great. But there's a wee tester to see if I could do this, and I think I'm doing well. So 8th, Birmingham City, 7th, Everton, 6th, Leicester, 5th, Arsenal, 4th, Spurs, 3, Man United, 2nd, Liverpool, and the winners of the Champions League, Man City. Next up, FA Cup. It's going to be a final. When did we get knocked out? We got knocked out by Man City in the in round 6. So we were so close. Carabao Cup, did we do? Again, it's Man City v Liverpool. When did we go out this time? We went out to Spurs in round 4. And Champions League. Next, Champions League. We didn't even get out of the group. So we've went to Europa League. Have we done well? We're not in the final though, so we've not won it. This has been a poor season. We went into the round of 32. So did we go? We went out to Roma in the round of 32. Oh God. This was an awful season, but has any of our players grown? Sanchez has got a downgrade. Boateng stayed the same. Danny Rose stayed the same. We probably could have. I can't wait for FIFA 22 because they've got £1 billion. But this was just a wee tester, and I think what we've done. Now I'd like to see who got the most goals. So first off, appearances: Mbappe, Muller, Pope, Boateng. All of these players that definitely. But goals, I would like to have a look at the goals. So Mbappe got the most with 20 goals. Muller got 15 goals. Sanchez got 11. And Bellingham got 5. Boateng got 1. And Danny Rose got 1. So that's actually quite decent from all our signings that we had. I'll take that. And obviously, and Nick Pope didn't get a goal, but made 51 appearances, which is really good. I think we've done well. So, thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.